When I Get Older, The Story Behind Wavin Flag, by Kanon, illustrated by Rudy Gutierrez. My name is Kanon. Until I was 13 years old, I lived in Mogadishu, a city that was like a sparkling jewel. Mogadishu is in Somalia, and sits on the Horn of Africa. The entire Indian Ocean was my backyard. Boats came and went all day long, bobbing on sky-blue water. I lived with my mother, my brother and sister, and my grandfather in a bright white stone house in the center of the busy city. My grandfather was one of the most famous poets in all of Somalia. Whenever I didn't feel well, he would recite his poems to me as we watched the sunset. His poems were like medicine. They told the best stories I ever heard. We didn't have a lot of money, so we often made our own toys. We made skateboards out of old wheels and pieces of wood. One day, my friends and I rode our skateboards while holding onto a truck. We were afraid to let go and the truck took us far away. We got in big trouble, but my mother never stayed mad for long. One morning, I woke up to a scary sound like angry bees coming from the street outside my window. There was gunfire everywhere. Was this what war sounded like? We couldn't play outside anymore. Everyone was frightened. My grandfather wrote me a short poem and we read it aloud together. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. My mother wanted us to leave Somalia and move somewhere safer. Every day she walked to the government buildings to try to get us the official papers we needed to allow us to live in a new country. I was frightened when she went out into the street. But my mother was brave. One day, my mother came rushing home with the special papers that would take us across many oceans to America. I was happy that we would be safe, but I was also afraid. My friends couldn't come with us, and neither could my grandfather. Poems will be your courage, my grandfather told me. Just say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom. Just like a waving flag. Our new home was New York City. The buildings were as tall as 10,000 men, and the cold wind bit me on the back of my neck. We lived with my uncle in Harlem. I couldn't understand anyone. The clothes I wore were all wrong. I was embarrassed and confused, and I missed Mogadishu. At night, I thought about my grandfather, and I whispered to myself, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When you come to a new country, you need a lot of papers. We didn't have the right ones to stay in the United States, so after 6 months we had to leave again, this time for a place called Toronto, in Canada. Canada gave us new papers and a new name, refugees. I didn't know what that meant. My mother said it was a name for people who had to leave a country because it wasn't safe. Canada was calm, and it felt safe. On the first day of winter, it snowed. I had never seen snow. I wore my sandals to school because I liked how the snow felt on my feet. But everyone laughed at me. My teacher told me I should wear boots. It was hard to learn a new language, but by the time the snow melted, my English was getting better. A boy called me a mean name and said Africa was dirty and ugly. I got really mad and I punched him. My mother had to come to school and talk to the teacher. Mom told me I should talk about my feelings instead of fighting, but this isn't always easy to do. Talking is better than fighting, but singing is even better. There were other kids at school who had to leave a home far away and who struggled to learn a new language. We all looked different, but we all liked to play and we loved our music class, where we got to sing. Songs are like poetry. I told my new friends about my grandfather and the poem he wrote for me. They told me I was a good singer. Singing made me feel as if anything were possible.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
At the end of the school year, the teacher announced that we had to sing a song in front of the entire school. I asked my friends from different countries and my friends from Canada if they wanted to sing my grandfather's poem with me. I wasn't afraid anymore. Grandfather was right. Music made me safe.
When I get older.